Hi guys, in this video we are going to take a look at contingency table analysis, and this is going to help us review some of the probability rules that you guys should know for the test. So for this specific question, we're looking at two things. We're looking at party affiliations such as Republicans or Democrats, and whether they oppose or favor laws that basically encourage electric vehicle sales in the United States. Now let's open up regular Desmos calculator on the side, and I need to fill out the row and column totals. It's pretty easy to do that. I think in my head I can do some of these, so this is easy, but you always come, you know, take the calculator. If you're in doubt, just plug it in there. Okay, so here we got 118, here we're gonna get 78. And then the total, whether you are adding the row totals like 196, so that would be 196, and also the column totals, that should give you the same answer. So always on the test, figure out if it's the same. If it's not, then you messed up somewhere. All right, so the next thing is answering the questions on probability. The first thing you should always ask yourself is this conditional probability or not? If it's conditional, usually there will be a part of a sentence that will say, given that something happens, what is the probability? Or if something happens, what is the probability? Now, that did not happen here. So this is regular probability. If it's regular probability, you are dividing by the grand total in the table. Every one of these things. Do not forget. Don't just leave the numerator. It's favorable over total. Okay, it should be a number between 0 and 1. So if it says, what's the probability respondent is a Democrat, you're taking the number of Democrats, which is 96, and dividing them by the grand total. And now if you want to round, the Desmos has a command round. And then because it says 4 decimal places, I'll go ahead and say 4. And here is my answer. So I will just, you can, by the way, copy paste it just to make sure that you didn't mistype, as I was just about to mistype. Okay, so the next question says, what is the probability that the respondent opposes rules? So opposes, again, you are taking the total in oppose, and that would be 118. And again, we are dividing it by the grand total in the tables. And then it says 4 decimal places. Okay, so that looks like probably the 4th decimal was a 0. So that just means it's 0.602. Okay, now this one is the one where a lot of people mess up. So this is that end or intersection or overlap. What's the probability respondent is a Democrat and also a person who opposes rules? So it has to be both Democrat who opposes rules. So how many Democrats oppose? 33 out of, again, grand total, which is 196. So let's take a look at that. So let's see what that is, 4 decimal places. So that would go here. The last question before we get to the conditional probability and independence is the additive rule. So additive rule is used to find probability of one thing or another. So you can see this or right here. It's either Democrat or someone who opposes. So that is where you just simply use the rule. And all that means is that you're going to add the probability of a Democrat, which we already have. So I will just use that. Add the opposes, so that, and then subtract the probability of the overlap, because we do not want to double count it. So that's why we subtract. Okay, so that will give me this blank. All right. Next is the conditional probability. So again, how do I know it's conditional probability? Because it says, if the respondent is a Democrat, what's the probability respondent opposes? Okay, so when you read the question, concentrate on the if part. If respondent is a Democrat, that will be on the bottom, that total number of Democrats. So if you go back over here, what is the total number of Democrats? It's 96, because you are now sitting inside the Democrat world. You can't get out of it, okay? So you are among the 96 Democrats. How many of them oppose? Well, 33, so that will be the answer here. Again, if it says round to 4 decimal places, I will just do that. Okay, so that goes in here. Now, this one is different because it says, if respondent opposes, so the opposes is the given, and that is what should be on the bottom. Always remember, whatever is in the if or given part goes on the bottom. So you are now opposing. You are among the people who oppose. So your total now is 118. How many of them were Democrats? Well, 33. So that is the same top, but different bottom. All right, so that is the conditional. Finally, independence. Now, some of these things you've already computed. For example, probability of A and B, this is intersection or overlap. You computed that right above the additive rule. You computed that here. So this is a Democrat and somebody who opposes. So I literally take this number and just copy that. Oops, sorry. Just copy that over here. Now, except here it says round to two decimal places. So always make sure that you're following directions on the final exam on the number of decimal places. So I am going to round it to two because that's what they tell me. It's very important because if you don't round, you may have actually your next answer will be incorrect because you didn't round correctly. So here you got 0.17. Now for this part, this is P of A times P of B. We have done that. We have probability of a Democrat here and probability of opposes here. So we just need to multiply them. So I will just type what they are. Okay. And then whatever answer, I want to round that to two decimal places. Okay. So like right here, comma two. Okay. So that is 0.29. So if these two sides, probability of A and B and probability of A times probability of B, if they are the same, then yes, they answer independent. If not, they're not. So very clearly, we can see that 0.17 and 0.29 are not the same, which means that these events are not independent. Okay, so let's go ahead and submit, and we are done with this.